Hey all, welcome to Tutelinks. In this tutorial, we will create a Ubuntu virtual machine on Azure Cloud Platform and associate it with 1TB disk. And then we'll see how to mount that 1TB disk onto the virtual machine. But before we begin, subscribe to this channel and keep yourself updated with the latest tech. Provide the proper name for the resource group. Give the virtual machine a name. Leave the default region as is as West US. Choose the image as Ubuntu Server 18.04 LTS Generation 1. Change the SKU size to standard D2SV3, which has 2 vCPUs, 8GB of memory. For the administrator account, choose the authentication type as password and provide the username. Provide the password and confirm the password. For inbound port rules, choose to allow selected ports for public inbound ports and select SSH port number 22. By enabling SSH port number 22, you should be able to connect to the virtual machine using the administrator account that we have just created. Click on Next button to configure disks for this virtual machine. Under the Disks tab, leave the default option for disk options. Under the Data Disks, click on Create and Attach a New Disk. By default, a disk with the size of 1024 GB is chosen for premium SSD. You can always change the size by clicking on Change Size. See various options of sizes. I'll go on with the 1024 GB disk size. The source type, I'm leaving it as none, but you can always restore the snapshot or mount a storage blob onto this disk. I'll go on with the default empty disk. Also, feel free to provide a meaningful name to the disk. Leave the encryption type to default and enable share hard disk to no and click on OK. Keep clicking on Next until you reach on Review plus Create tab. Once the validation is passed, click on Create to spin up the virtual machine on Azure. The deployment is in progress. Wait for the deployment to succeed and then go to the resource to access the virtual machine on the Azure portal. Here I am on the virtual machine's homepage on Azure portal. Click on Networking and expose port 80 on TCP. Click on Add Inbound Port Rule. Leave the source as any and destination as any. The destination port ranges is given as 80. Select the TCP protocol and give it a name as port_80 and click on Add. Under the settings, click on Connect. As we have chosen the authentication type as username and password, select the username at the right IP address. Switch over to the open source command prompt CMDER and type in the command SSH space tutelinks at the rate IP address or SSH space username at the rate IP address. Hit enter and upon prompting, are you sure you want to continue? Type in yes and hit enter again. Provide the password and again hit enter. Upon successful connection, you will be landed on the terminal wherein you can access the virtual machine via SSH. Now let's look at the available memory on all mounted drives on this virtual machine. Type in the command df space hyphen h and hit enter. We see that the new disk with 1 TB of space that is attached while creation of the virtual machine is not showing up here. So let's work toward mounting the 1 TB disk on this virtual machine. Now we wish to see all the disks that are attached with this VM. So in order to check that, make use of lsblk command. So as we can see on the screen, we can recognize our new 1 TB disk that is attached to this VM by looking at the size column and that says 1T, and the name of that disk is STC. Now we will format the new STC disk of space 1TB by showing the parted command as shown. Notice that the parted command recognizes the STC disk with /dev/STC. Once we have successful partition on formatting of our disk, the new disk will be identified by its default first partition as /dev/stc1. So we'll make the file system of that new disk. Now we will let the kernel aware of our new partition and file system by issuing the partprobe command sudo space partprobe space /dev/stc1. Let's make a directory and give it a name of our choice. This will be the directory where we will be mounting our new disk of 1 TB. To make use of the mount command to mount the partition STC1 onto the data drive directory that we just created. Now let's run the command df space hyphen h again to see if the new disk partition is mounted onto our virtual machine. Now that we have successfully mounted the new disk of size 1TB onto the virtual machine, we also have to ensure that upon the reboots of this virtual machine, this disk will be remounted safely without any failure. For that, we have to add the universally unique identifier, or simply UUID, to the fstab file in order to take care of the disk mount during the reboots. So let's do that. Make use of blkid command and look for the UUID of the disk that we want the operating system to mount during the reboot. Copy the UUID of the new partition SDC1. Open the fstab with the editor of your choice. I'll be using nano. Provide the UUID of the new disk that we have copied at the very end of the fstab file as shown. To summarize what we are doing here in the last line, we are mapping our new partition whose UUID is mentioned to the directory named data drive, and it is of type file system xfs defaults comma nofail, which indicates that the operating system not to fail if at all it is not able to find this partition during the reboot. Save and exit out of this file, and you are done with successfully mounting the partition onto the Ubuntu virtual machine. If in future you want to mount another disk, navigate to the disks section under the settings of the VM on Azure portal. Click on create and attach a new disk and provide all the necessary details. And then SSH to the VM and mount the disk identified by its size or LUN number as already shown in this video. Congratulations, you have mastered attaching new disks and mounting them on a virtual machine deployed on Azure. If you found this video useful, please give it a like and share it with your friends and colleagues. And one important thing is to do subscribe to this channel and keep yourselves updated with the latest tech skills. Thank you and have a great day.